Good day to you all. Today I'd like to share some thoughts about the five senses: sight, hearing, touch, smell, and taste. My thinking was stimulated by a meditation I read on Saturday. It is by Friedrich Buchner, and he wrote as follows. Listen to your life. See it for the fathomless mystery that it is, in boredom and pain of it, no less than in the excitement and gladness. Touch, taste, smell your way to the holy and hidden heart of it, because in the last analysis, all moments are key moments, and life itself is grace. As I reflected on this meditation, I thought of how we have experienced boredom and pain in our lives during the lockdown and the effects of the pandemic. We have also experienced excitement and gladness. For many people, it has been a time of loneliness and sadness, feeling far away from loved ones, and even when we are close to them, unable to give hugs to express our love. But for many people, it has been, and still is, a time of drawing closer to God, of experiencing the simple, smaller joys in life, of experiencing key moments, moments that create memories, moments that remind us that the gift of life is indeed the gracious gift of God. Saint Ignatius of Loyola, a Spanish priest who lived in the 16th century, said this: God meets us where we are, as humans living and breathing in a tangible world. And the five senses are five entry points for God's love to become known to us. Our five senses help us to be in touch with the reality of our world. As I sit here at my laptop, I am in touch with the world and my life going on around me through my five senses. I can hear the humming of my laptop. I can hear Ian scratching through a container of screws, looking for two the same size. I can taste the knickknacks I'm eating from the bowl next to me. I can feel the keys on the keyboard as I type, and I can see the letters come up on the screen in front of me. That, at this moment, is my tangible world, the reality that I am experiencing. Here is another example from my teaching past. When introducing new concepts such as shape and number to preschool children and to older children, it is important to help them experience those concepts using as many of their five senses as possible. Take the concept of number. To help children learn about the number two, we first talk about their own bodies: two arms, two legs, two feet, two hands, two eyes. They can see their bodies, they can feel them, and they can touch each part of their body. Then they handle real objects, such as two shoes, or two blocks, or two books. Then they look at pictures and have to find two things the same in a picture. Then they go on to draw their own pictures representing the number two. As they use their five senses, they gain an understanding of the concept and of the number two. In another example, if someone is suffering from anxiety and stress and maybe has a panic attack, using their five senses can help them focus and take their minds off their worrying and frightening thoughts. They are encouraged to find five different things they can see and to look at them in detail, to listen for four different sounds, by using physical touch to find three ways to interact with their environment. To name two things that they can smell and find one thing that they can safely taste. This exercise helps to ground a person in the reality of the world around them. However, the thought comes to my mind of how many people, sadly, many of them children, be they young children or teenagers, who are so glued to social media and the internet that they are unaware of the reality of their lives and the world around them, and end up living in a virtual, unreal world with virtual friends, a virtual reality. This takes me back to what Ignatius of Loyola said. God meets us where we are, as humans living and breathing in a tangible world. So I ask myself the question, what is my tangible world? And I ask you the question, what is your tangible world? We can use our five senses to meet our great Creator God where we are. I am fortunate to have a lovely big garden to walk in and to sit in. I see the trees and shrubs in their different shades of green and in different sizes. I can feel the texture of the leaves and grass. I can hear the birds singing. I can smell the fragrance of the flowers. I can pick a fresh tomato and enjoy the taste of it. Where is your favorite tangible world, which you can experience with your five senses? Is it the beach and the seaside? Or the mountains, valleys and rivers in the Drakensberg? The animals and birds in a game reserve? Personally, I love being on a farm with the sounds and smells of the animals and freshly ploughed land. I love watching the cattle come in for milking. Maybe you are confined to home at this time, but you too can use your five senses to find the grace of God in your life and the wonder of God in your tangible world. In Scripture, we read how Jesus helped people use their five senses to know the reality of life and the grace of God. In John chapter 20 and verse 27, we read the account of Thomas having his doubts removed when Jesus said to him, "Put your finger here, see my hands, reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." So Jesus encouraged Thomas to use touch and sight and hearing, and he believed. In Matthew chapter 11 and verse 15, Jesus said words which are familiar in other places in Scripture. "He who has ears, let him hear." And in Romans chapter 10 and verse 17, Paul says, "Faith comes from hearing the message, and the message is heard through the word of Christ." So next time you read your Bible, notice how often the five senses are mentioned. Think of the key moments in your life and how, whether in the boredom and pain of it, or in the excitement and gladness, through using your five senses, you can come to know the grace of God. So let us pray. Father God, you created our world and you created each one of us so that we can touch, smell, see, hear and taste your goodness and feel your grace in each moment of our lives. There are times, Lord, when we don't understand what we are going through in life. So please help us to find you in those moments in a real and tangible way. When our faith is challenged, encourage us like Thomas to see and touch you that we may believe and know and experience your love and your grace. Thank you, Father, that whether we are experiencing boredom and pain or excitement and gladness, you are there. Thank you for your love. Amen.